This video shows how to sample for lead in your drinking water. First draw sample shows how much lead is in the water when the faucet has not been used for many hours. Flush sample shows how much lead is in the water after the faucet has been running. Depending on the purpose of your sampling, you may need to collect one kind of sample or both. Both first draw and flush samples should be collected from the kitchen sink. Open your sample kit and remove all the contents. Carefully read through the instructions from the laboratory. You will need a waterproof pen to fill out sample bottle labels and paperwork. Let's start with first draw samples. These should be taken first thing in the morning or any time after the water has not been used anywhere in the home for at least 6 to 8 hours. Place signs on all the taps and toilets as a reminder. Do that the night before if you are sampling first thing in the morning. If the kitchen faucet has a water softener or point-of-use filter, collect your sample from a tap that does not have either of these. If the faucet has an aerator, it does not have to be removed. To collect your sample, place an open sample bottle, it may be marked first draw, below the faucet opening. Turn on the cold water tap as though you were filling a regular glass of water, and fill the bottle to the fill line, or to the shoulder of the bottle if a fill line is not indicated. Be sure to capture all the water coming out of the faucet and not allow any to run down the drain. Tightly cap the bottle. If there is a label on the bottle, fill it out as directed by the lab. Next, if you're collecting a flush sample, run the water from the same tap for at least 30 seconds. Turn the water off and place an open sample bottle, it may be marked flush, below the faucet. Then follow the same instructions. Turn on the cold water tap as though you were filling a regular glass of water. Fill the sample bottle to the fill line or shoulder and turn off the water. Tightly cap the bottle and fill out the label. Next, fill out the laboratory paperwork as directed. Make sure that everything on the sample bottles and paperwork is complete and correct. Place the sample bottles and paperwork into the shipping container according to the laboratory instructions. Call the lab if you have any questions. The results will be mailed to you directly, usually in about 2 to 3 weeks after the laboratory receives your samples. For more information, please visit the New York State Department of Health's website at www.health.ny.gov.